In the next case, let's get back to the documentation, and here this is the background attachment in the first position that we are looking about, and we can see that these are the classes, those been used right over here, this kind of BG fixed, which has a property of background attachment fixed. So what it is supposed to do? Let's say over here, this is the fixed class. So it says use a BG fixed to fix the background image relative to the viewport. That means the background image property should be something like this one. It will be fixed into the position where it was placed. So that is why if we use this class, copy this use class, get back to your project. And in the first thing, all we are going to do, we are practically going to remove this BG red 500 class right over from here. And on the other hand, we will be removing this hover class right over here. Sorry. There it goes. And instead of these classes, we may use here this BG fixed class that we had just recovered. Now, if we press Ctrl S, have a closer look over here. If we press Ctrl S, get back to our project and reload, we will see that nothing is happening right over here. This is not the same as it was seen here. That means the background image is not fixed to the position where we had placed it in the first place. So what we should do? Get back to your project, and the second thing is that this kind of properties, this kind of classes, the property that is associated to this particular class of BG fixed, it won't be working under this condensed version of background properties. That means this is practically the condensed syntax along which we may use several properties such as the background image, the background attachment size, repeat or no repeat condition, anything we could have used right over here. So this is the condensed syntax, but this won't work along with this particular class of BG fixed. So in an order to make it working, all we need to do, we need to use this background image syntax right over here in the first case. And in the next case, all we are going to do, we are going to use the background repeat condition here. Press Ctrl S. Now, if we press Ctrl S, if we get back to our project now, we can see that this background image is now practically fixed into a particular position, and we can see that the rest of the contents, those are practically scrolling over it. There it goes. So this is the first thing. In the next case, if we get back to the documentation right over here, this is the BG local to scroll the background image with the container and the viewport, and this will be the result. And in the next case, use BG scroll to scroll the background image with the viewport but not with the container. So if we use here BG local, there it goes. If we use this class here, BG local, and if we press Ctrl S, we can see that it is practically in accordance to the relative width of the viewport. We may see that it is practically scrolling the background with the container and the viewport. Both of them are practically moving. In the same manner, if we use here this BG scroll, then in the same case, we'll be seeing something different right over here, but I guess that won't be easy to discriminate right over here. We need some additional things into it. We'll be definitely defining about it in a later tutorial. Now up to this far, we can say that this has been done right over here up to this far. In the next case, all we can do, we will be getting back to this background position. There it goes. Now here are the classes associated to this background position. We can see that this is the BG bottom, BG center, left, left bottom, left top. So all of those classes are being defined right over here. But in the first case, we will be using this background repeat property, because there are so many repetitions right over here. We won't be working with the repetition to understand the background position. That won't be a very good effective way to see things changing into our project. That is why in the very first case, all we are going to do, we are going to use these properties right over here, like this BG no repeat. If we use this BG no repeat property here, then we will be practically preventing any kind of background repetition into our project. So in this case, all we are going to do, we are going to use this BG no repeat condition, and we will be ignoring any kind of rest of the classes those been used right over here. So there it goes. We have BG no repeat class. That means there will be a property of no repeat condition for this individual image, background image practically, that we have used into our project. This is the supposed theory that is working behind it. So if we now get back to our project and reload, we can see that we have practically got rid of repeating our background image right over here, and by default it is taking place in the extreme left and top position. Now in this case, the first thing that we are going to do, we are going to use get back to this background position. First of all, this is the BG bottom class that we are going to use. So we will be using here BG bottom. Press Ctrl S, get back to your project and reload, and you can see that this is the BG bottom property that has been practically working right over here, and the image is now positioned at the bottom. In the next case, instead of BG bottom, if we wish that our image, it should be taking place, this is the background image, that should be taking place in the right or in the left or in the central position, then all we need to do, we need to use those corresponding classes. So this is the BG center class that we will be working on. There it goes. Get back to your project and reload. This is the BG center class. In the next case, we are going to use this class of BG right. Reload, this is the BG right class.